गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे लेट अस डू पेज नंबर 21 वर्कबुक 13th क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो आई एम रीडिंग द 13th क्वेश्चन. लिसन, रीड द कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मिस्टर श्याम एंड मिस्टर एलेक्स एंड हेल्प मिस्टर श्याम टू फिल द फॉर्म. हियर देयर इज अ कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मिस्टर श्याम एंड मिस्टर एलेक्स, सो वी हैव टू रीड द कन्वर्सेशन एंड हेल्प मिस्टर श्याम टू फिल द एप्लीकेशन. ओके, आई एम रीडिंग द कन्वर्सेशन. लिसन, मिस्टर श्याम, गुड मॉर्निंग. मिस्टर एलेक्स, मिस्टर एलेक्स, गुड मॉर्निंग. व्हाट कैन आई डू फॉर यू? मिस्टर श्याम, आई वांट टू बी अ मेंबर ऑफ द लाइब्रेरी. मिस्टर एलेक्स, ओ दैट्स नाइस. टू बिकम द मेंबर ऑफ लाइब्रेरी यू नीड टू फिल अ फॉर्म. अनदर थिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड हियर इज दैट यू नीड टू फिल द फॉर्म इन बोथ द इंडो अरबिक एंड रोमन न्यूमरल्स. Here Mr. Shyam want to be the member of library and he want to further he has to fill a form. So we have to help him to fill the form. So he has to fill the form with Indo-Arabic and Roman numerals. Okay, now let us do the form. Okay, 13th question A. So in the first one he has to write his name. So it is already written. So there is no need for us to do anything there. So in the B question, he has written his date of birth. So that is 26/12/1988. Okay. In the B box, he has written his date of birth, and we have to convert this into Indo-Arabic numeral. We have to convert the date of birth into Roman numerals. Okay. So let us turn it into Roman numerals. 26 and 12 means XII and next 1988, 1000 plus 900 plus 80 plus 8. So 1000 means how much? 1000 means M. 900 means how much? CM. 900 means CM. 80 means how much? 80 means LXXX. And next 8 means BIII. So he has written his data book in Indo-Arabic numerals and we have converted into Roman numerals. Next, in the C question, he has to write his address. Okay, he has written his house number. In the C question, he has written his house number, which is 756. His house number is in Indo-Arabic. This Indo-Arabic numeral and we have to now convert it into Roman numeral. So this is 700 plus 50 plus 6. 700 means CDD and 50 means L and 6 means VR. Okay. So we have completed the house number. We have converted the house number into Roman numeral. Next, D question. Street number. In the D question, it is given the street number. But the street number is written in Roman numeral and you have to convert it into Indo-Arabic numeral. L means 50. So we have converted the Roman numeral into Indo-Arabic numeral. Now let us see the D question. That is pin code. So now in the E question we are having the pin code and it is given in Indo-Arabic numeral and we have to convert it into Roman numeral. It is 32,412. First, what you have to do is we have to write 32. We have to write 32 and place it under bar. So first you have to write 32 and you have to place it under bar. Bar means you have to multiply the number inside the bar with 1000. If you multiply 32 with 1000, it will become 32,000. After writing the 32,000, we have to write 400. 400 means CD. 400 means CD. Then you have to write 15, which is XV. Did you understand, children? Here, the pin code is given in Indo-Arabic numeral and you have to convert it into Roman numeral. For that, what you have to do? First, you write down 32 and put it under bar. Bar means what? Bar means you have to multiply the number inside the bar with 1000. So, inside the bar, how much is there? 32. So 32 into 1000, which means that 32,000. After that you have to show 415. 400 means CD and 15 means X read. Okay, did you understand children? So next, the city name is given and next country is given. So no need of filling the next two boxes. Okay, did you understand children? Now let us do the 14th question. So did you understand children? We have completed the application for Mr. Shyam. Now we are going to do the 14th question. So I am reading the 14th question. Listen. A Roman emperor decided to test two of his courtmen. So the Roman emperor, what did he want? He want to test two of his courtmen. So Russell and Taurus. Their names are Russell and Taurus. He sent them to buy eggs with the same amount of money. So he has given some money and he wanted them to buy some eggs. Okay. The one who would bring more number of eggs to the court will be the winner. He told them that the one who brings more eggs for the given money will be the winner. So Russell bought XXIIX and Taurus bought XIXX. Who won the contest? So Russell bought how many eggs? Russell bought XXIIX. So what is XXII in Indo-Arabic numeral? XX means 20, II means 2, which means 22. So Russell bought how many eggs? 22 eggs. Now let us see how many eggs did Taurus bought. Taurus bought XIXX. X means 10 and IX means 9, which means 19. So Russell bought 22 eggs, Taurus bought 19 eggs. You know that 22 is greater than 19. So who won the race? Who won the contest? Russell won the contest. So Russell won the contest. Did you understand, children? The king gave some amount to Russell and Taurus and he asked them to bring some eggs. So those who get more eggs for the given amount will be the winner. So Russell bought 22 eggs and Taurus bought 19 eggs. Okay. So you all know that 22 is greater than 19. So Taurus won the contest. Okay. Now let us move to the 15th sum. Let us move to the 15th sum now. Okay. So I am reading the 15th question. Four friends, Venkatesh, Yami, Deepika and Samuel, participated in 100 meters race competition. The following are their jersey numbers. So four friends. What are their names? Venkatesh, Yami, Deepika and Samuel. These four friends have participated in a race. So they have been given some numbers. So Venkatesh was given the number CLBII. Yami is given the number CDL. Deepika is given the number LBI. And Samuel is given the number DC. So the person who was wearing the jersey with the smallest number took least time to complete the race. Who took the least time? We have to find out. Okay. Who won the race? You have to find out who has won the race. Did you understand, children? Four friends have participated in the race and they are having some numbers. So the person who is having the least number has won the race. Now we have to find out who is that person. Okay. Now let us write the friends' names. First one, Venkatesh. So Venkatesh is having a jersey with number CLBIII. So you all know that C means 100, L means 50, BII means 8. So next, who is the next one? Yami. Amix number is CDL. Amix number is CDL. C means 100. Sorry. CD means 400 and L means 50. 450. Next, Deepika. Deepika has a jersey number. Jersey number LVI. So L means 50, VI means 6. 56. Then the last one is Samuel. Samuel has the jersey number DC. Here, DC means how much? D means 500. C means 100. That means 600. So, the Venkatesh number is 158. Yami's number is 450. Deepika's number is 56. Samuel's number is 600. So, now who is the winner? What did he told? The person who is wearing the jersey with the smallest number. Who is the person among them who is wearing the jersey with smallest number? That is Deepika. So he has completed the race. He has completed the race at the least time. So Deepika completed the race at the least time. So Deepika is the winner. Because she is wearing the jersey with the least number. So Deepika has won the race. Deepika has won the race because she is having the jersey with the least number. Here it is given that the person who is wearing the jersey with least number has completed the race. So Deepika is the winner. Okay, students, did you understand? Okay. Now let us do next one. Next question, that are choose the correct answers. Okay. Let us do choose the correct answers. Page number 23. Page number 23. Choose the correct answers. Choose the correct option. First question. Which among the following is a Roman numeral? Here the option for A is 0, B is V and C is 25. These three options are given here. Which among the following is a Roman numeral? You have to find out which among this is a Roman numeral. You all know that V is a Roman numeral. So you have to tick B. Okay. You have to tick B. Next, second question. Which among the following is an Indo-Arabic numeral? Which among the following is an Indo-Arabic numeral? Here I am writing only the options, children. I am reading the question and writing the options here. And B is M and C is X. Here these three options are given here. Now what is the question? Which among the following is an Indo-Arabic numeral? You have to find out which is the Indo-Arabic numeral among the three. So you all know that 3 is the Indo-Arabic numeral. Now let us do the third question. The Roman numeral of 5 is. So you have to write down the Roman numeral for 5. The options given here are A1, BX, CB. So which is the answer? The Roman numeral for 5 is B. So you have to tick C. Next, fourth question. Next, let us do the fourth question. Let us do the fourth question. I am reading the question, children. The Roman numeral of 50 is. You have to write, check the Roman numeral for 50. The options are A, L, B, C, C, D. So which is the Roman numeral for 50? You know that Roman numeral for 50 is L. Okay, tick A. Next, fifth question. Fifth question. Dash is the Dash is the Indo-Arabic numeral for D. You have to find out the Indo-Arabic numeral for D. Okay. The options are A 500, B 100, C 1000. So which is the Roman numeral for D? 500 is the Roman numeral for D. Sorry, 500 is the Indo-Arabic numeral for D. 500 is the Indo-Arabic numeral for D. Okay, children. I have done 5 sums. Remaining 5 try to do on your own. I will be giving the answers in your WhatsApp so that you can check your answers. Okay. Next, in page number 24, we are having application part. I am reading the application part. You try to complete the application part. Okay. Look the house numbers of 7 houses in your area where you live. Write the numbers both in Indo-Arabic and their corresponding Roman numerals. What you have to do is, you have to write down the house numbers of 7 houses in your area, and you have to write them in Indo-Arabic numeral and also in Roman numerals. First you have to write the house numbers, then you have to convert them into the Roman numerals. Okay. And you have to complete the 7 questions given below. Okay, you try to do on your own. If you can't, I will be giving the answers in your WhatsApp so that you can check them. Okay. Next, C3 part we'll be doing after coming to the school. Okay. That's all for today's class. From Monday onwards, I will be starting the new chapter. Okay. Bye.